Hey, awesome ones. So I really have to thank you all because a few weeks ago I put out a video and it was on 7 mistakes, a kind of what not to wear theme, and it's on its way to 500,000 views. So thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you so much. And I thought what I would do today is let's do a part two. And if you missed part one, I'm going to put it on the end screen of this video. So let's start with mistake number one. Here goes. It's stop wearing your in-between clothes. And you're probably thinking to yourself, all right, Heather, what the heck are you talking about? And I know a lot of us as mature women, we're trying to lose a few pounds, right? And so we keep all those clothes that are really too tight for us in the closet for someday. But someday really doesn't come. And here you are, you're doing the dieting and everything, and you're not really losing the weight. Sometimes you're even gaining weight. And every time you look in your closet, you're kind of, well, you kind of feel like a failure. So it's time to do the trash and donate. And hey, I held on to a lot of really expensive suits for a long time. And then I realized that there's someone out there, you know, going on a job interview that really, really needs this. So I donated it to one of those causes. And I feel really good now because it's with someone who will love it. So let's take a look at an example of an in-between outfit. All black and oversized to hide your weight gain. And trust me, this go-to outfit can last for years. That's what it did with me. But let's change this. Here I have a current up-to-date look and I added some color to my life. No more drab and boring me. Now I can embrace life every day and not feel like a failure. The bright pink blazer, which is a trending color right now, is just the ticket to boost your spirit and your self-esteem. And in case you're interested, it's around $75 and available also in other colors. I matched it with this mostly cotton shirt for about $23 and this NYDJ jeans, and they stand for Not Your Daughter's Jeans. They're made for us more mature women and they have tons of stretch. This style is called Sherry Slims and I have on the Habana color. It's around $99. They also come in other colors too. So I put on a stretchy belt for $12, a pair of skin tone kitten heel sandals for $38, and my big sunglasses that I got from Zara for $36. A great purse at $36, and that kind of tops everything out. Now let's take a look for a moment at these two looks side by side. If you see yourself in the first photo, I really do think it's time for you to get out of the drab and into the fab. Now, looking at that last example, I say it's time to embrace your curves and just love you as you are right now, and stop hiding, stop wishing for a thinner size, and just be happy with what you have. And you know, of course I'm going to say to eat right and do some exercise, but it's just important that you really, really love yourself. So thanks for listening to that. I think it's so important. All right, so let's go on to mistake number two, and that is that you're covering up too much and it's time to show some skin. What? Now, when I say show some skin, I'm not talking about, you know, those cut-off Daisy Duke shorts or micro mini skirts. I'm talking, well, for example, me. I have spider veins, but I like my legs. So I like to show them off a bit. And you know what I've found? People aren't really looking at you the way you think they are. Hey, as a former model, I should really be self-conscious about these things, but you know, I do like to hide my upper arms a little bit, but maybe your arms are your best feature and you want to show them off, or maybe it's your décolletage, I think that's what it's called. Anyway, a lot of women your age are doing this now. It's perfectly acceptable to show a little bit of skin, and let's take a look at an example. Here, I've hidden my legs, my arms, and even my neck. I tried to look summery with sandals and a white shirt, but this covered up look isn't working for me, especially if it's 100 degrees outside. We can do much better, especially in the warmer weather. I really like my legs, but I still want to hide my upper thighs, so pencil skirts and longer skorts like this one are a go-to for me. Here I have a look for warmer weather that includes a skort, which is simply a skirt with shorts underneath, and this longer, stretchy one is available for about $40, and it comes in lots of colors. I love the polka dot top and the V-neck. It's so comfy and cool, and it's available for about $26. I kept the black kitten heels on this look because, you know, it's kind of a dressier look, and they're available for $38. The fold-up polarized Wayfarers by Ray-Ban for $213, they top off the look. So what's mistake number three? Well, you don't want to have fun with fashion anymore, so you really play it safe with what you wear. And I say that's a mistake. It's time to liven things up a little bit, so let's take a look. How about a summery Panama hat? Or maybe a new style of sneakers. This one has a side zipper. And you're never too old for a baseball cap. And you don't even need to have a logo on it. I could go on and on because I do have fun with fashion. So go ahead and pile on those bangles, or maybe, you know, get a pair of cheap sunglasses that are a kind of a wider size, or maybe even get yourself a pair of leopard print Crocs, which I'm going to elaborate on these a little bit later. And again, let's get back into having some fun in the sun. And if you like videos like these, modeled by a more mature woman, don't forget to subscribe. There's a button down there somewhere. And also don't forget to click on the bell. All right, let's take a look at mistake number four. It's wearing big undies like these underneath kind of a slinky dress. Now, I have to admit, I wear these, you know, underneath maybe one of those skorts. But if I'm wearing a slinky dress, I love these undies from Jockey. They are so light. They hardly have a seam at all. And you get them in three different colors. And they're, I think they're about $17 for the three of them. And another thing is, for my skin color, I really like the beige ones for underneath like a white pair of pants. You do not want your seams showing underneath a white pair of pants. And as usual, I'll have a lot of the after fashions for you underneath the video description and also in the comments. And if you're interested in seeing a lot of my favorite fashions, just go to amazon.com/shop/awesomeover50 and scroll down and you'll see all the fashion sections. I've got things there from swimsuits to skorts. All right, so let's get into mistake number five. And it's wearing cheap flip-flops. So here I have a bargain brand of flip-flops. Hey, we've been wearing them for years, and when the weather is warm, they're our go-tos. But I've learned the hard way that cheap flip-flops, you know, where your heel bangs on the pavement and there's no support, will make you pay in the long run. Heel spurs and pain in the arch of your foot seems to crop up. One thing we don't want to do is sacrifice style, so I like to wear summer shoes like these great ones by Crocs with a fashionable animal print design. Notice the arch support and the heel padding. You know the Crocs name, and these are available for about $23 in lots of different colors and patterns. And by the way, I love those Croc flip-flops so much, I just bought them in a skin tone color, so I'll show them to you later. All right, so I know I quote my grandmother a lot, but one of the things she always told me was, make sure your shoes are in good shape because people look at your shoes. And you know what? She's right. So what I have on hand at all times is a little shoe kit like this. And I just don't wear those shoes that are all, you know, kind of scuffed at the back because you've been driving, or maybe the boots have those salt stains. And so I've just got a little kit like this, and I'm always sort of touching up my shoes. And when I get new boots, I'm making sure I'm putting on the winter protector. The next mistake is that you've been buying clothes that aren't authentically you. Maybe you've been shopping in the same store, you know, for mature women, or buying the same brand over and over again, and you know, they're just not you. For me, I love to go for walks, so a look like this makes me feel youthful and gives me the exercise vibe. Here I have a stylish yet comfy top for walking or playing tennis at $28, the same white skirt, and a pair of Adidas Stan Smith sneakers at $72. I topped off the look with a black baseball cap and my favorite Ray-Bans. Next, I really feel like a fun-loving person, so the boho chic look fits my personality well. This is a go-to look for me while visiting craft fairs or festivals. And I have a long blue dress on for $39 and my newest beachwear cover-up at $26. It's lightweight and airy. The side slit really helps me to show a little bit of skin, and a long necklace, elastic bandeaus, my leopard Crocs, and a floppy hat finish the look. For look number three, I love getting dressed up. And if you're going to a wedding or a fancy get together, get your groove back by feeling pretty again. I know I've showed this beautiful dress before that has a designer flare with its sleeves. It's still available for $32 and also available in many other colors. And the gold shoes at $28 really polish off the look. So I wanted to add one more suggestion to this video, and that is, let's stop looking at our birth certificates. Let's start thinking of our personality age. And for me, it's age 43. And you know, you don't want to be going into the teenager years of the 20s, but again, 43, it's a time when I was really blossoming and turning into authentically me. Think about what your personality age is and let me know in the comments. Also, I would love to know what ideas really resonated with you. You know, I just love being here, and I would love to help you go from drab to fab. And for me, it's just one more way to keep it awesome.